All right, so this is your girl Queen Nick, and I'm back with another video. So, and welcome to my channel. For the ones that are new here, welcome. And my queens that been here since day one, y'all know, y'all my girls, and thank y'all for watching. Y'all please subscribe and like this video. So today I am going to Roses to get me some gowns and stuff, and pretty much document my process of my surgery. I do have my pre-op tomorrow at 11 o'clock. I think I have to be there like 15 minutes early, but I need to go ahead and get some stuff for get some stuff for my surgery. So y'all coming with me.
Yeah, okay. You need to get done at work. Come over. We just need to slow the motion. Don't get out of the way to no one. Long distance, I need you. When I see potential, I just gotta see it through. If you had a twin, I would still choose you. I don't wanna rush into it if it's too soon, but I know you need to get done if you come over. Sorry if I'm way less friendly. I got niggas tryna end me all. Yeah. I spilled all my emotions tonight, I'm sorry. Rolling. How many more shots until you're rolling? We just need a face to face. You could pick a time and a place. You'll spend some time away. Now you need to forward and give me all the
work. To me, I'll be work. You see me do me da. Just tell me about that work. Na. When you walk out, na. Before the table,
saying to y'all, I'm about to get ready to have surgery. Today is Wednesday, and so I will be, I'm just prepping myself up for my surgery. I'm going to go in more details of what the surgery is about, but right now I'm just going, just stopping. If y'all see a little mark right here, it's a bump that I had busted a few days ago, and it's not exactly on my lip. So yeah,
Yeah,
Yeah, okay.
You need to get done at work. Come over. We just need to slow the motion.
Oh, it's a tripod.
Let me record. And I would still choose you. I don't wanna rush into it if it's too soon, but I know you need to get done if you come over. Sorry if I'm way less friendly. I got niggas tryna end me. Oh, yeah. I spilled all my emotions tonight. I'm sorry. Rolling. How many more shots until you're rolling? We just need a face to face. You could pick a time and a place. You would spend some time away. Now you need to forward and give me all the
work. Work. To me, I be work. You see me do me da. Just love me by that work.
Alrighty, you guys. So I have got my stuff ready. I'll show y'all. I also ordered some stuff on Amazon. I'ma show y'all. So I'm leaving Roses. Finna go somewhere else. I think I'm finna go to the dollar store. Cause I got some few things that I need to get from there. And then probably headed home. Yep. Well, alrighty, y'all. I guess I'll talk to y'all later, okay? Today is September the 14th, and this is just like a pre-op for my surgery next week on Tuesday, but I'll keep y'all updated. About to go in here. Alrighty, so what I was telling y'all I had to check in, but I'm having surgery today. Well, not today, but next Tuesday, which will be September 19th. I'll go more in detail of what I want, why, and just let y'all know that I'm here and I'm trying to get as much footage as I can. But yeah, this is my pre-op, so I got a lot of papers to sign and blood and everything, so I'm trying to get little footages of it, okay? So I'm going to get my blood work now. So that's what I'm showing you. Oh, I'm so tired. About to end it now, y'all. So just waiting on them to call me back. So I'm just sitting in the waiting room, as y'all can see. I'm tired. Stomach is hurting like crazy. Gotta go to work right after this. But yeah, just waiting so they can take my blood, so they can run tests on it. I have to come back here Monday. Again. So yeah. Yeah, she told me that I had to come back to y'all Monday.
Yeah.
Is it a specific time?
What now, sorry?
Is it a specific time?
No, anytime. Okay. Yeah. And then Lynn from pre-op, or Lynn, Susan, or April will call you from pre-op. So just keep an eye on your phone.
Okay.
They're in charge of like your grand procedures, stuff like that.
Okay. Do you know what the time frame would be?
No, she didn't say.
Okay. Okay. I'm about to get some blood work. I'm so tired. My stomach is killing me. They need to come home. Like, for real. Hey.
My name is Keith. I'll be doing the aisle.
Okay.
Is that this? Something about 20 minutes. The restroom is right across the hall. And it's a gray box and then you can leave it in.
Okay.
All right. Anything else I can do for you?
No, ma'am.
You have a good day.
You too. Thank you. just left out the lab, getting my blood, and also they got my urine. So, I gotta come back Monday to get more blood work before I have my surgery. I have my surgery Tuesday, so that's that. I'm just like, I'm not all the way there, so like I was saying, I had to come back there Monday to get some more blood work. So I don't know if they're gonna do another urine, but they're pretty much just gonna run tests on my blood and do all those, you know, the test runs to make sure, you know, my blood is good, all my levels is good and everything, because they really didn't explain shit to me. I guess I had to answer the question, I don't know. But anyway, this procedure is something that, is it, that look like, I don't know, is that Mimi or what? But this procedure is pretty much me getting surgery on my C-section scar, because every time I period, and if it's too much information, y'all can scroll through the video, but this is pretty much gonna be explicit anyway, because it's me, you know, pretty much getting surgery. So I'm just gonna be 100 transparent with y'all. So yeah, I've been having issues with you know, having heavy periods. I'm always tired. My pelvic area, always having some type of chronic pain that just, I was just trying to figure out what is going on. Police just pulled somebody over. But yeah, I'm just trying to figure out what's going on. In 2020, like around April, I was having some real bad, I was just trying to figure out what was going on, because I was having issues. I found out I have a knot right there on the, you know, on where my C-section scar is, and it hurt, like, especially when my menstrual is on. So it was giving me trouble. So I went to the doctor. It was another doctor. It's not this doctor that I'm going to right now that's doing the procedure. But I went to the doctor and told them what was going on. And they were saying they was going to do a laparoscopy, which is meaning that they're going to use a camera and also check for endometriosis. So I did a procedure in April, and they said they couldn't find anything. But I described to them what was going on. Like, I have this lump right here. I'm also having pain when I have, you know, sex, and I just know I'm not myself. So I just basically, I feel like after I had the surgery, I feel like my period got worse. Like, the pain even got more intense, where I couldn't really bear with it. But I was like, nah, it gotta be. He said I ain't got it. So I don't know what's going on, but I still have this lump right above my C-section scar, and it still hurts each and every time my period come on. During my, you know, just after the you know, my period and everything like that. So I go and get a second opinion again, which is this year. Fast forward to this year of 2023, August the 23rd, I think that's when I went to see him. And he was like, do you have any other issues that you want to discuss with me? And I was telling him, I need you to touch this, you know, this little knot on my stomach. Like, it hurts. It's very intense. when I touch it. And he was like, so when he touched it, he was like, oh, it's such endometriosis scar tissue or something like that on your C-section scar. And he was like, 1 out of 10 women gets it once a year, da 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 this. And I'm like, okay, well, why the first doctor didn't catch this? Like, I've been having this excruciating pain for I feel like it's forever. So fast forward to now, I, you know, got my pre-op done today, and also I had got blood drawn, signed papers, got to go back Monday and pretty much do some more blood work. So yeah, I wasn't really given like not to, I mean, the only thing that I was given was not to eat after 12. So any type of like bowel movement, any type of like, you know, doing any type of using the bathroom and stuff, like cleaning out my system, which I was gonna do anyway, but I just felt like it should have been more information what I needed to do the day before of surgery, but they didn't give me no information. So it's like I'm really just winging it, and also listening to people on the YouTube of what their experiences is. But I'm not getting I don't think I'm getting a liposcopic surgery. I think he said he was going to make incisions, like just to cut it out of me. I'm going to show y'all everything. I'm going to be as transparent as I can. Because I know other women. Wow, I got something in my eye. I always got something in my eye. But I know other women probably dealing with this. I would suggest that you always, you know, talk with your doctor and stuff about the situation, and he can diagnose you of what's going on, because it can be something different. But mine's right now, I am pretty much diagnosed with endometriosis on my C-section scar. And it just really upset me, because it must have been taken care of in 2020. And I was told wrong that I didn't have endometriosis. I don't know, is it different from, like, you know, having actually endometriosis on your C-section scar? But I can't really find any type of documentations on YouTube about, I found little information, but it's still not, like, I'm still not understanding, like, the concept of what's going on. And, you know, I totally understand it's 1 out of 10 women, but why I had to be that one, you know what I'm saying? And I don't know, it's just very difficult. And I feel like people don't make it, I feel like how their reaction to it doesn't, they don't make it seem as it's like it's that serious. But the day-to-day life is serious to me. It's very serious. And I'm just ready to get it over with. I'm ready to get it over with. Oh, and they did give me some soap, because I had to bathe my body with some type of soap. So, this soap that they pretty much gave me, and also the appointment that will be coming up. And it's crazy, I will have to wait to talk to the doctor till the day of my surgery to get more information of what's going on with me. Well, the questions that I want to be answered, like, will this shit come back? You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't, like, is this really the cause of me not able to, you know, not getting pregnant? Because endometriosis also can be infertile, make you infertile. So, I don't know, is that the cause of me or not? But, yeah, it's crazy. It's crazy. So, yeah. So I'm just back home, y'all. I'm about to get ready for work because I'm about to get ready to just go to work, you know. And yeah. Said I'm supposed to get a call today, but I feel like I'm going to miss it because I'm gonna be at work. So it's, I don't know, I'm not really truly like, I'm everywhere, y'all. So please forgive me if I am. Please forgive me if I am. I may redo this video, I don't know, but right now, this is what y'all gonna get. You know, this is just how really gonna get. And yeah, that's it. I will show y'all what I am packing when I do go to surgery and stuff. So I got a lot of stuff that I purchased yesterday. Y'all actually came with me. If y'all seen the video, y'all will see what I have, was some of the stuff that I let y'all see that I might take some stuff back though, because I think some of this stuff just overpriced to me. But anywho, I got a couple more stuff that's coming from, I ordered some stuff on Amazon. I ordered me some slippers and stuff. Some more slippers for me. You know, try to make me feel good. I'm gonna treat myself this weekend if I'm not doing anything too important. I'm trying to treat myself to clean up the house and everything, so I won't have to worry about being in a dirty house. But yeah, I'm just gonna let y'all go. And I'm about to get ready for work. I am so tired, but yeah. Hey, just wanted to say, my endo girls, y'all understand what I'm going through. Most people don't know what you're actually really going through, but y'all endos girls, y'all know. Y'all know what I'm going through. So, I'm kind of overwhelmed and kind of upset, and I don't know how to explain it to you, because you feel like you have a person that actually know what they're talking about and you trust them. You know, you already don't want surgery anyway, because soon somebody cut on you, you're going to always have problems, because as you see, got a C-section and it's causing me problems. So it's like, I don't know. It is horrific. Like, so crazy. I can't believe like I'm going through this again, and now I gotta take off for work. Which is cool. I need the break from work anyway, but it's just like, this supposed to be taken care of. This, like, you tell the doctor and you think that they gonna listen to you. They don't really listen to you. So hopefully this one actually listen and get all the stuff out of me that's not supposed to be there, which is the endometriosis. I'm still learning, y'all. So about this, they call it, it's supposed to be a disease. So it's possible that it can come back, but I'm not for sure about my situation, because it's like, some of the women, it's like it's on their ovaries. It can be pretty much anywhere in your body, but mine is on my C-section scar. I don't know what I'll be able to show y'all, but I don't know, because I'm not really comfortable. But I know I will be showing y'all the results of the aftermath. So yeah. But yeah, I'm just gonna end it here. Hope y'all have a beautiful day. Y'all continue to watch this video. This is very educational, and this is what my experience is. So if y'all haven't experienced, you know, these type of symptoms, y'all definitely need to talk to your doctor, your OBGYN, to see what's going on with your women's health. Your health is important, especially women, because we are basically the backbone of our family, so we have to take care of ourselves. So I just hope this is the last thing I can, you know, take in, because I don't want to continue to keep having surgery on the same issue. Because it's like I said, this is my second one. First time it was a fail because they said I didn't have it. So yeah, just couldn't figure out why I was going through what I'm going through. And now I kind of got a solution, but I want to get the actual factual information, you know, once they go in there and get it, because that's how you're going to actually know that it's endometriosis. So yeah, but I'm about to end it here and find me something to eat because I'm hungry. So I'm about to get this. Today is Monday, so I'm about to go get some more blood drawn and run tests on. So yeah. Hey. S H A N I Q U E.
E.
Yes, ma'am.
And date of birth?
July 26th, 1992.
All right, give us a few minutes.
All right.
My daughter name is
Shelly. For real.
I don't know why I didn't think you put A in there. I put S H I.
Mm-hmm. Her name is H.I. All right, so I'm waiting for them coming back so they can do some more blood work.
It's on the bed.
Mm-hmm.
Make a fix for me. Big stick. I think it's your face.
Okay.
Oh, thank you. So I have to keep this on?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so y'all just got my blood drawn and it gave me this for the hospital, so let's see what tomorrow brings.